In last week's video, I asked you if you could help me solving the 90 degree kick drum response time problem. You sent in about 100 sketches, and I was just overwhelmed by this feedback. It's amazing. So I thought that we go through them together, and I'll look at your sketches, and by the end of this video, I'm gonna make up a new ID for version 4 of the 90 degree kick drum based on what you are suggesting. Okay, rigid rod type IDs. So how about eliminating some of the slack by exchanging the cable that goes from the pedal up with a stiff rod from Tobias? There is definitely something here. The cable on my version was like vibrating around, and I think a stiff rod would increase the stability of the whole construction. Janis from Latvia also suggests a carbon rod. Dear Martin, as a professional organ builder of 30 years experience, I saw the video Tidy Drummer, by the way. I think he's talking about Marcus and not me. I think it's a great idea, and I do not believe that the extra axis is a problem. I think the lack of response is due to there not being a rigid connection between the foot pedal and the upper pulley beater assembly. Gear drive 1,000 times cooler than a basic direct drive. Totally agree. Hi-hat remote cable mount or brake cable type IDs. These things. Actually, on the version 0 of the kick drum, I tried this. And I might have bought a too cheap of a system, but they are infamous for breaking. Maybe on a more industrial scale, like what Adam is suggesting here, the Bowden cable could be a third option to try out. Cocktail kit type IDs. I don't know if you ever heard of cocktail drum sets. They have bass pedals that hit the bass drums from the bottom. So you put a chain around like this, like David is suggesting, and you beat the drum from below. And Hugo from Mexico is suggesting the same. And I think cocktail kits would definitely work. It would feel the same for Marcus, and he could also play on the top of the kick drum. There would be nothing on the top, so he could like, but I don't think it's visible enough. Version 3 type IDs. Paul Arne Johansen sent this one, and I love it. But all the version 3 solutions struggle with something, and that's that this arm of the beater needs to be very long, because you need to hit the middle of the bass drum, but this arm will only go 5 centimeters over the rim of the drum. What Vincent got right here is the proportion of this axis to the length of this beater. I think that's the same proportion as on a normal kick drum like this. What we need to understand here is that there's a gear ratio going on here, which means that if Marcus presses the pedal 3 centimeters down, the beater will move 10 centimeters, and this gear ratio is important to make the pedal feel like a normal kick drum. So if we increase the beater size to hit the middle of the drum, I think we also need to increase the size of the axis, and that will be just double amount of mass to move. Cajun pedal type IDs. Dani Rodriguez from Spain sends this. This looks on the surface actually exactly what we need, doesn't it? Like a Bowden cable kind of ID. He sends a YouTube link. Let's go to YouTube. Oh, yeah. Oh, did you see this? This was, I was watching this yesterday. It's the SpaceX 14th of January Falcon 9 launch.
You're looking at a live view of the Falcon 9 rocket carrying 10 Iridium.
I love how they just put Earth into the address because they want to colonize Mars. And so now you have to actually add which planet you are on to get a correct address. And they have come up with a system with recyclable rockets. So they actually start the rocket, and then the start engine falls down to Earth and lands on a drone ship. I have to show you that. Sorry. I got so sidetracked here. Where is it? Where is the landing? You will forgive me for getting sidetracked on this.
The Falcon 9 is in startup.
The vehicle is in startup.
Whoa!
Now those scared fans are powered by nitrogen thrusters, and they're used to actually steer and guide the rocket back down to Earth.
This is a single-engine landing burn, so it's a slower decrease in speed.
Wow. You can actually see the deck of the Hestus right now. Wow.
Okay, where were we? Cajun pedals. I mean, if they can land a rocket backwards, I should be able to build a kick drum. That is 90 degrees difference, don't you think? Cajun pedals.
大家好，这是 Dixon 的卡后 pedal。那这卡后 pedal 是圆圆的这个鼓槌的部分，哈，棉球，就像这样子。
I see what he's doing here, it's gonna be cool. Yay! It looks flimsy. Here's another video that Andrew sends. Ah, this looks a little... This looks beefier, actually. The Cajun pedal ID might not be so bad after all.After seeing them in action, I actually think I should buy a Cajun pedal, the beefiest one, and have Marcus to try it. Okay, improvements of version 2 type IDs. Team of Freeman, I think it was the rope that caused the delay, even though the steel rope can't stretch the way it's installed, make the beater a little bit loose. Yes, it's right about that. That's a beautiful sketch, Timo. Hi Martin, I had an ID.If you make an axis with two different gears or cylinders, you can increase the sensitivity and maybe this could reduce the sloppiness from ballast. This is interesting. This would cause Marcus to have to press longer with his foot, but it will be lighter for him to press. Wow, this sketch looks like Leonardo da Vinci drew it. It's very beautiful. Michelinius.Austin from MIT has sent a Poiselier-Lipkin linkage. Linkage capable of transforming rotary motion into perfect straight line motion. Pedro, what is this? This is really different from all the other solutions actually. Rigid bar. Wow, this is cool.This would also be super cool because the audience would then see the kick drum pedal from the side like this. But it has one problem and it's the gear ratio. I saw that now. You would have to move the pedal 10 centimeters to get 10 centimeter action on the beater. That's why this doesn't work. But I loved this solution. Low tech, face the drummer away from the audience. That's a really smart solution actually. Ah!That was all the sketches. Thank you so much for sending them. It's been so fun looking through them. And I'm going to go into Photoshop and make a mock-up of a version 4 now, based to what I've learned from your feedback. this kind of feedback, it's fantastic. It feels like I have hundreds and thousands of friends helping me out, and I can't thank you enough for that. It's so fun. Thank you so much, and see you on the next Vintergatan Wednesday. Bye.